Attention bobsled riders! You will soon be embarking on a thrilling podcast down the icy slopes of the Matterhorn. So please remain seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the bobsled at all times. Auf Wiedersehen! Hello, yodelers. We are the Matterhorn Yodelers. I am your host today, Peter, with my co-host...
Jackie.
And...
J-Fifth.
And we've got someone that decided he wanted to jump in on our special episode today.
Father Yodeler.
Father Yodeler. Yes.
We're glad he's jumping in today. It's always a pleasure when you're here.
Well, good. Thank you. I appreciate it. I heard some good words on one of the previous podcasts, and I said, well, let me check it out.
Yes, I've gotten a lot of feedback from your last visit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they said that you raised the bar when it came to the windows.
Oh.
Yes.
I raised the windows.
You raised the windows
on
the Windows episode. So, you kind of jumped in on one of our meetings and found out we were doing a music episode, and you're like, oh, I want to come.
It sounded like something I didn't have to prepare for.
Nope.
Something I already know something about and am fond of.
Welcome to our podcast where we don't prepare for anything.
I'm the only one that prepared for this episode.
Unless I've got some novel that I'm going to read off to you guys.
Right.
Usually I have to prepare, so this is great.
Yeah, so this is going to be a fun musical episode where we're going to be listening to music both old and new.
Is this like the story when you like tied Jackie to a chair and you're going, which one is it?
No.
Which Beauty and the Beast? Is
yes.
it stage production or is it the show or is it the...
No, not that. So the idea came about this because, you know, the topic always comes up of, you know, when an attraction gets built, he's like, oh, you can't tear down this attraction, it's so much better and things like that. And I've always had the policy of, well, as long as it's better than what was there before, I'm okay with things being replaced. But that may not be the true case scenario for the music, because Disney attraction music has changed a lot over the years. And so we're going to be looking at specific attractions, both what's there now and what was there before, and compare and contrast the music of those attractions and decide, did Disney do better or did they get worse?
The sound system has really improved at Disneyland. I will say
the sound quality. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So we're going to get started here. Let's start with something that we might all know at Disneyland. So here we have the current music for Space Mountain.
Somebody turn off the lights.
Right?
Just close your eyes, Dad.
Wee, oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Are we getting close to the picture yet? No, we got a ways here.
Oh, yeah. We got a ways before we hit the picture. But you can hear where the dip comes in. You know, you can hear it in the music. Here, if you listen closely, I think it's coming up here shortly. So this is the first drop right here. You get a small little dip, and then here's the big one.
Woo!
Oh yeah. It feels great.
I love this, soundtrack.
This is the best.
So yeah, I mean, great soundtrack. It gets you energized, gets you excited to be on Space Mountain. I love it. I think it's great.
This is the current music.
This is the current music.
Yeah, there was good. No guitar. There was no guitar.
Oh, that's right. I like that. Like Surfer.
Oh, yeah. Let's get to...
My favorite.
Surfer Space Mountain.
Oh, I forgot.
Like your Wonka's, like, ship.
Yeah.
Ooh, that eeriness. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Okay. This is when I'm
going to... Oh, going up the climb.
So this is where I'm going to start. I'm going to cut all this out before. Oh, wait. There's still...
Oh, It's a long climax.
It is a long.
We have ignition.
Oh, hang ten.
Ooh.
It's a great one too. It's
oh,
hard.
Oh, it's so good.
Get you in the mood. It's.
I think they should alternate it. That way, if you're right in for more than once, you may get both versions.
That would be so fun.
That would be a great way.
They couldn't do that logistically, though.
Why not?
Because you have tracks constantly going.
Yeah, but they do that all the time with the new Guardians of the Galaxy ride.
That's true. And the speakers are right next to you.
You can program the ride vehicle to play specific songs.
And it may not be, you know, every other, but it may be, you know, every
maybe there's just like one vehicle that plays.
Ooh, one vehicle.
And you make it like a certain color. Like it's like surfboard, right. Like
red.
Like the Julie Andrews carousel.
Right.
Board. Yes.
And it's like a special privilege when it comes to pulling. We got the surfer rocket,
and everyone's like, "Man!" And you gotta do the hang ten kind of symbol.
I like it. Disney, do it
for that one Imagineer that listens to us.
Yeah.
So, what are your thoughts and opinions on these two different these two pieces here?
They're still good. I like the new one,
both.
But the old one, that's my nostalgia.
That's like when you first started writing it too, right?
For the most part, yeah. That's the one where I really could enjoy the whole experience, including the music.
I like the newer one more. It's less beachy and it fits in more with the overall theme.
I think that's what they were going for.
Yeah.
But
the two are not like so different.
No.
And soundtrack.
They both give you the right feelings when you're supposed to have them during the attraction.
The intro, like the build up, is better in the second one. You don't know where you're going, but it is a weird transition where you have this like 1950s kind of like sci-fi,
right?
And then you're like, oh, hang ten, space dudes.
It totally is that like 1950s like space.
I feel like I'm at the like what is it at the Hollywood Studios at the
Rock and Roller Coaster.
Not Rock and Roller Coaster, the 50s diner.
Oh, the sci-fi.
The sci-fi diner. Yeah, where you sit in the booths with like the cars and you watch like old sci-fi like TV shows.
So the Surfer Space Mountain, was that the original?
No.
That was the first one they did. There were no speakers on Space Mountain
when it first opened at Disneyland. Okay.
So they may have had some music going in the back, some kind of sound effects going in the background, but there was no music per se.
There is no sound in space, Jackie. Why would there be any sound?
Can you imagine it's like a silent coaster?
Well, you know they've done like, they have this room that people can go into.
Oh,
tangenting off here.
No, I've heard about this.
But no one can stay in there longer than like a couple minutes because it's like acoustically so soundproof that the people start going mad. They start hearing their own heartbeat. They can hear their blood moving through them and they can't do it. They like they just leave.
So I watched a video and someone debunked that.
Did they?
Yeah, because they stayed in there for like...
They just put sound effects of your heartbeat to drive you crazy?
Yeah.
That's funny. All right. Well, so what's the general consensus? Are we split? Because I'm old. I like the old one.
You know what? As much as I like the old one, I think the new one's a better fit.
I'm kind of with the old one, but then like my...
I'm good either way. Like they're both really
they're
good.
Both good. I'm not upset about the new one.
No.
I think they both get 4 Mickey bars from my point of view.
Now, on some of the tangent the other ones they created when they did kind of a rock and roller theme or the Halloween theme. Yeah, I'm not into those.
I hated right. the Red Hot Chili Pepper one. Yeah, I hated that one.
No.
Star Wars one was the best.
Yeah. Star Wars, you can't top.
You can't beat John Williams on Space Mountain. That was awesome.
Though I have done Star Wars, like John Williams on Rock and Roller Coaster was not that great.
That would be weird.
It was weird because you still have like the rock and roll like posters and stuff.
Oh, we gotta get to the concert. You see this 90-year-old man rock out, dudes.
I came out of retirement again.
No, he's not retiring. That's the news of the week.
No, he's not retiring. And then Spielberg is doing a documentary.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to that.
Oh, I'm sure you are.
Yeah. I was only upset that Disney Plus, it doesn't sound like it's going to be on Disney Plus first.
No. That's a bummer.
If there's somebody that deserves their own documentary, it's John Williams.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
I've looked for books on him, and they're hard to come by.
I can imagine. He's not one to be like, let me sit down with a biographer and write my thoughts on things.
All right. So, since we're talking John Williams, we're not really going to be playing John Williams music. But I figured we'd talk about Star Tours for a little bit.
How do you talk about Star Tours? And not talk about
John Williams. Well, there is
another song.
Oh.
And you know what I'm talking about.
Oh. Curveball on Father Yodler.
So wait, so the first song, is it the original?
This is from Star Tours. And the one that we'll listen to afterward is from
Refurbish.
No, not Star Tours at all. It's going to be Adventures Through Inner Space.
Okay.
Okay.
So again, we got the old music and the new music. So let's listen to some of the cue music for Star Tours.
I thought this was like weird 80s music Dad listened to. I didn't know that's what this was from.
Yeah, it's called the Droid Room.
Yeah, it's not played very loud.
No.
Do they still play it?
I don't think they play it anymore. I don't remember. I don't think they play it since they've updated it, but they changed the theme of the room. It's no longer the Droid Maintenance Room. It's now Customs or whatever. Baggage check. But
yeah, I honestly thought it was 80s music. Totally. I had no idea when Dad played it in his cassettes in the car. I thought it was 80s music.
Star Tours. I like Star Wars.
You never knew. I know. So I was like, oh,
this is Star Wars music, but I don't know about this. Is different.
Yeah, there's no blue elephant playing this music.
Well, it sounds like it could be though.
It could.
Yeah, that's true.
So. All right. So then, now, let's move on to Miracles from Molecules.
Was that their...
Take Me Back.
Miracles from molecules around us everywhere. There are miracles from molecules.
Silence is consent. Everyone loves this one.
I don't think I've heard this before.
You got Sherman Brothers music here. I mean,
definitely speaks to the time period that it came out.
Yeah.
So, just a catchy tune for a very unique ride.
It was the attraction
Can you explain what the attraction was?
You got into a little... Doom buggy, same type of vehicle as the Haunted Mansion is now, and you rode it through a microscope, and you actually saw the microscope and people riding through and getting smaller as they went through. It was very exciting.
It's a really cool trick that they did.
They did. Mm-hmm.
It would shrink them down.
So you get in it, and you end up being one of those people shrunk down, and you get to see snowflakes and molecules and somebody's speaking, a ghost host actually speaking, same voice, taking you through.
And then they inject you into a body and you go in through the veins to find, different attraction.
That was
Body Wars.
Spock did that one.
Yeah.
But no, it was the coolest attraction in Tomorrowland back in 68 when it came out.
Okay.
So what are your guys' thoughts? Are you okay with kind of like background noise music, or do you like the music that you can listen to and potentially sing along to if it's something that catches your fancy?
Well, I like the background noise for like line cue.
Right.
So I get the Star Tours like 80s like sound.
The molecule one. It kind of, you know, makes me want to go like to Leave It to Beaver, you know, the good old days, the nuclear family.
Totally.
Yeah, I mean, I thought it's a very catchy tune. It's Sherman Brothers. They are the masters of writing catchy tunes. And I think it's a magnificent piece. Obviously, over time,
forgotten.
It gets forgotten. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why I wanted to bring this one out, because it is a great piece that should be appreciated a little bit more.
But if you ride the attraction that's there now, the only thing you're going to remember is the John Williams music.
And that's why I didn't put the John Williams in there, because I felt like that was just going to like...
Easy.
It wins.
To be honest, when I rode the Adventure Through Inner Space, I don't remember that song being played. It probably played when you were exiting.
I think it was an exit.
Trying to rush to your next attraction, so you didn't spend a lot of time listening to it. you were mostly running to your next attraction.
Come on, Dad. I can't imagine you as a kid. I can imagine you as a kid hanging out with a garbage can with a big microphone boom. You know, what are you doing there? Oh, I'm just hanging out here. Recording music.
It was a little later in my life.
Security already knows who you are at Disney.
Well, you know I haven't been there in a while, and there's a reason.
Let's go to Disney. Nah, I'm good. Nah, it's overrated. Here, record this for me.
That's great. It's great music, both ends. I mean, yeah, it's hard for me to pick, because they come from two separate time
so
periods.
Yeah, they're so different.
So, but let's switch things up. Let's go back to things that we are a little bit more familiar with. Let's start with what's currently there at this attraction right now.
Is this Autopia?
No.
Oh my goodness.
It's the Incredicoaster.
Oh, is it the Incredicoaster?
Yeah. Oh,
okay. Different parts. Okay.
Jack Jack's loose. Laser beam's getting fired.
Pew pew.
You got the screamers.
Yeah.
You'll have like me that's screaming like a Yeti, like, you ruined my recording.
I always, for some odd reason, when we get to the loop, I always yell, here comes the big papa. All right, and now let's compare it to what was there before, when it was called California Screaming.
It's always California Screaming.
Yeah.
I know, right?
Oh yeah, just that anticipation hearing this.
The anticipation was really good on this.
Because I had that old school fare, and you're like, oh, we're going on a roller coaster.
There was a lot of critique on a lot of California Adventure when it first opened. This was a knockout with this music.
Yeah.
We should should have had fans blowing each other's face for this part.
I like the new theming, but I lean towards this music for the intensity for the music part of it.
And I love this part because you're going, yeah.
No, this is the climb. Oh, this is the climb. This is the big hill climb. And then we get the... Like...
Heart-bumping music.
They wrote this beautifully.
Yeah. Oh,
and
yeah.
And then they got special music for the loop. Here, listen. This is the loop. It's so good.
It's a headbanger.
You know what? When you're on the roller coaster, you don't sit there like, let me just absorb the music in this moment. No, I never really appreciated it till this point. You know, like just the beginning, you focus on the music because you've got nothing else. You're standing still. There's not a lot of stimulation besides your heart racing and you hear this music. So it's so iconic. Like when you mention it's like, this is the ride.
Right.
It sticks with you. And that build up, but listening to the music, you're like, you know, it's there, but I didn't realize, like you said, Jackie, it's a headbanger.
It's
like,
totally
I was like, oh, this is fun.
You could like go for a nice jog with that music. Like,
it's more akin to Space Mountain. The original.
Yes, I was thinking.
And probably they were thinking along that line when they.
I don't know. They both give like such a different like change to the coaster.
I like the theming of the Incredibles.
Oh, I do too. I think to put a movie to the coaster, Incredibles was the perfect fit.
It's a very difficult ride to retheme. It's an open roller coaster, right? A traditional
And they make fun of that. They make fun of that in the queue. They're like, "Oh yeah, retheming an old roller coaster. Wow, how original!" You know.
Yeah.
How about this idea? What if we switch it between rides?
Yeah, that's a novel idea. I don't think we've talked about that before.
But my preference, I like the OG. Like, it builds, like, the intensity more.
It does. I agree.
I think there's more of a thrill with the original song. With the new Incredible song, it's more of just like, ooh, this is cool.
Cool
going
jazz,
that. Yeah.
1960.
Right.
I'm slick.
Again, Incredibles music, beautiful.
Oh, also.
Amazing music. But this, you know, the original soundtrack for California Screamin' was specifically written for this roller coaster. So like every moment, every bank and turn was specifically written for that roller coaster.
So you got Giacconi doing the music for Space Mountain and Incredicoaster. So
right.
The two recent versions were both done by him.
I didn't realize he did the new version.
Yes.
Of Space Mountain. Okay. So it sounds like we're all in consensus that the original...
OG.
I think there's more of a thrill with it.
Okay. You heard it, Bob. Let's get the OG back.
Well, I think he was a part of the change.
Well, Chapek was in charge of the parks at that time, too. So,
I don't know. You had Eisner going around like, hey, you see that? See that lampshade? I did that. Yeah, that's right. I see that wallpaper? I picked that out. So you never know.
Well,
yeah.
Eisner's picks for California Adventure was fairly limited. Let's have a tractor... Just have a farming area that doesn't have anything at all. It's just, we have a farm area. There's nothing there.
But... It would be fun just to play with a tractor.
So we can retheme it with Disney CEOs, you know, chasing each other.
And then when you hit the big, like, drop, that's when you meet the board. They're like, no.
And at the end, you have Walt Disney shaking his head.
Like, oh, my gosh, what's happening?
You destroyed it all. It's just Walt's frozen head. He just shakes it back and forth in his little tube.
So depressing.
Man, I feel really bad because I was sitting here. I was going to do Buzz Lightyear, but I didn't put Buzz Lightyear's music on my thing. So I'm like, well, I have what was there before. What was there
what
before?
What a buzzkill.
What was there before Buzz Lightyear?
Rock and roller coaster. No, rocket rods.
Rocket rods. Rocket rods had a theme song.
Sure. Oh yeah.
They had... So let's at least listen to it.
Short lived, long line.
Right.
So always broke down.
And it even had words. I was blown away. I was listening. I was like, this has words to it. Okay. Like, I remember hearing the music, but never the words. So here we go.
So what broke down more? Indiana Jones or Rocket Rods?
Rocket Rods. Oh, yeah.
Your faces are like, what? I had to include this.
The line was so long. I loved this music because it was the only thing you had. There was the Circle Vision movies they played in the background.
The Forever Room. Yeah.
The Forever Room.
You spiral in and then you spiral out.
Yeah.
That is how the line worked.
I like the song, except for when it came to them singing, like, the lyrics. It's just like, it threw me off.
It's garbage.
Yeah, at first I was just going to grab just the, you know, just the music, and then I heard the words, and I was like, oh, we're doing the words. We're going to get that one in there. But, yeah, it's just kind of fun.
And then you're going to play Buzz Lightyear, and this is our reaction.
I'll put Buzz Lightyear for our audience to listen to, and they'll say... Rocket Rods was probably better than what's playing at Buzz Lightyear.
Yeah.
I like Buzz Lightyear, but when it worked, Rocket Rods was really fun.
Yes. It was fun. And then you realize, oh yeah, we're going 60 miles an hour on a...
I don't think you ever did.
I never rode it.
The vehicle only held four, right?
Yeah, you were probably sitting out because you were too young.
I was probably way too little.
We just put you in a stroller and pushed you into the bushes. And you're like, shh, don't move. The mermaids will eat you.
Oh, that's why I'm afraid of mermaids.
One of the moments I'll never forget was we were in line for Matterhorn and it broke down right when we were next, and they gave us go through the exit passes, and we're like, go to Rocket Rods, and we got right on.
Yeah,
like,
that worked well. Hey, it's working. Let's try it.
Right.
Because you get in line, and it's like over an hour wait,
and then it breaks down
before you get through that hour.
Was it fun?
Yeah,
it was a fun attraction. I enjoyed it when we did get to ride it. I only remember a couple times breaking down, but I just remember going, oh, it's down.
It's just a fast people mover is all it is.
It would launch you and then it'd slow you down.
And it replaced the people mover.
So it's like, what's it, the attraction over at Epcot?
You're talking about Fast Track?
Yeah.
It's similar, but not. Fast Track's actually built for that.
Right.
This was not.
No.
I'm surprised one of those didn't get, like, one of those rocket rods just didn't get launched into the hub.
you lose a lot of that theming about, oh, this is how we make cars and things like that. You don't get that theme. It's just, you're getting into a fast car, zoom, you're going.
Right. It's a great ride, but definitely short-lived. All right, now let's fly across the nation. Let's go to Disney World.
Disney World, cool.
We've got some Disney World music. There's actually a lot. There's a lot of Epcot. I had to take some of it out. I was like, no, we're not going to do that one.
We do Horizon sometime.
Horizons is on the list.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Oh, yeah. In fact, let's do it. We're talking about it. Let's talk about what's there now.
Horizon was replaced by Mission Space.
Yeah, right. The open trash can ride.
Yeah, the open trash can.
Yes. Yeah, they allow open trash cans there.
Oh, yeah, that's right. They do, because people are throwing up.
And now they have them at the Guardians of the Galaxy coaster.
Oh, do they?
Yep.
Oh, they got a second attraction that allows
right next to each other.
Well, that's pretty smart. The custodial guy just hangs out with the mission space guys most of the time. He was really cool. I like that guy.
So this is the music you hear when you exit the attraction at Mission Space. Very romantic sounding.
Total like early 2000 pop.
Is this the one that I listened to? It sounds different.
This is Horizon.
This is Horizon?
No, this is
Space Mountain.
This is Mission Space.
Mission Space after you've ridden it. Okay.
Like when you're walking down the long exit.
You're mostly holding your hand over your mouth.
This is a different person singing.
It might be a different person.
I think, yeah, it's the same song, but somebody else did, because the other one would bellow out, and you'd just be like, oh, please stop.
Yeah, it is a different person.
That was the version I had, so.
This is a more muted version. The other one was all like, she was belting it. This one's actually easier on the ears.
JP's has a tear down his eyes.
I'm just saluting. You made it. You made it to Mars. You saved us. Gary Sinise is proud of you.
You're just at the exit just clapping. Good job.
Good job. No vomit. Not you. Not you. As one guy's like, raises his head out of the garbage can. I'm sorry, man.
I didn't make it.
You didn't. Shame. And I'd walk behind them with a bell. Shame. Shame. I didn't last very long. I don't know why they'd want me there part-time.
Why they want you back there, yeah.
Stop humiliating the guests.
And then that attraction replaced a beloved attraction by many Disney fans that grew up going to Epcot in the 80s and early 90s. Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. I was like,
here we go.
I like the children's choir.
They do a better job than the children in Epcot Forever.
Yeah.
their nighttime show.
They should just put this at the end of Mission Space.
Nobody'd notice.
No.
No one would notice.
The cast member that has to stand there for 45 minutes at a time will.
If you can see me. Yes, we can!
I love this. You hear the children.
It adds a lot.
There's so much more passion in the Horizon one.
I have hope for the future right there.
I like the Horizon one. That's a win in my book.
Yeah, I would definitely.
I agree.
Vote for that.
Well, I definitely didn't like the original song. I found it torturous. People were like, "You stayed at the Tiki Room and you liked it?" And I was like, "Oh yeah, it was way better than Mission Space. That was torture."
The Mission Space one was just like an early 2000s, like in a 90s film, or
it was bad.
Yeah.
But yeah, so it sounds like we're all saying bring back the old music.
Yeah, just bring it back, the Horizon music at the end of Mission Space.
Yeah, I mean, you could play like Apollo 13 music, something like epic, like you accomplished something. That one is just, no, I don't care for it.
No.
All right, let's go to World Showcase. Now that we're in Epcot, let's go visit the Mexico Pavilion, the Three Caballeros.
Ooh.
I didn't know there was a difference.
Oh, there is.
There is.
Oh, do I not have it up? I do. I hit the button. There we go.
I love this ride.
Oh, it's anytime I went to Epcot, I had to go on it.
It's this music that made me appreciate the movie Three Caballeros more than before.
Oh yeah,
I agree.
Just a better, sharper recording of it than than the original 40s.
What, the ones in the
Absolutely.
40s? Yeah.
This movie was always on in our break room at Caribbean Beach. Always on.
We at Hook.
It's a good fit.
Is this the current or
that's
was it?
The current?
Current.
I
that's
like
the
it.
Current.
It's good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now before they before it was the Three Caballeros attraction, it was called El Rio del Tiempo. That was the name of the attraction. So I'm gonna kind of skip.
So
ahead
the river, the temple river.
Yes. So I'm gonna skip ahead here too.
Good.
I know. Gosh.
Well, from what I've heard. The Three Caballeros, that's the way.
Oh, of course.
I would say the new version of it's better. I will probably put the other music on over this so that...
But I'd say the live mariachi.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
That's
outside,
the best part.
That trumps all.
The best part is the part with the chef where he's sharpening his knives and he's like like looking in a daze as like Donald's
he's
whirling
not,
around.
He's not really following Donald.
He's just like, whoa, I'm a chef.
Also, during COVID, I enjoyed the live mariachis because they would perform on the YouTube while the parks were closed. And those were very enjoyable. You can look those up on YouTube still under the... Parts blog or
the
YouTube
Mexican
channel.
Mexican Pavilion has one of the better entertainments in the World Pavilion.
It's probably one of the best pavilions. I think it's...
Yeah.
It gets overshadowed,
cool,
though.
Literally cool...
inside area, yeah.
It does. You walk in and you're transported.
You are.
To...
Especially when you go in the middle of the day, you walk in and it's like, oh, it's nighttime. It's not so bright.
It's
and
relaxing.
You don't want to leave.
And then you leave, you're like, oh, I don't want to. We'll
oh, what's
back.
Next? Oh, Ligonberry in Norway.
Let's go to the Stave Church, everyone. So, all right, let's move on. Let's go flying on Soarin'.
Mm. Okay.
It's ready. This is the original Soarin',
oh,
not
definitely.
The not
this
not,
is,
not the
oh,
new
yeah.
one.
This is Jerry Goldsmith. Oh yes.
This is the best.
This is the better version.
It's like a president. It's like Air Force One level, like
Jerry Goldsmith did Air Force One.
Oh, okay. My bad.
No, that's not bad. You are tuned in to his music. He also did the music to Mulan.
Yep.
I just watched that this morning. Fa Mulan.
All right.
Oh, that was good. I like that. That was
yeah,
that triumph.
That
I feel
good.
Like you're just breaking the crest and you're just floating over the bay.
Perfect music.
And you might ask yourself, what attraction did it replace? Because they literally built it next to the pavilion. Well, they had to destroy a show for the queue. For the attraction.
Oh.
So you've got the show?
I've got Kitchen Cabaret.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I don't know. I'm kind of liking this.
Much better animatronics.
Yes.
So the ham used to be behind Stretch 2 at Haunted Mansion. So you'd see a big giant ham if you put your coat up. Because one of the workers there, he wanted to take it home. And so he was secretly hiding it.
At the Haunted Mansion.
At the Haunted Mansion.
Oh. Interesting.
Things you learn.
From Epcot to
I remember just walking
Magic
in and like
Kingdom.
That's I remember looking in there and I was like, that's the ham. Like from Veggie Veggie Fruit Fruit.
Right. You got the,
how's that here?
If you got it out of Epcot, why not?
Why bring it back into Magic Kingdom?
Magic Kingdom is probably more secure than Epcot.
His wife worked at the Haunted Mansion, so I don't know if he was waiting to get it approved or I don't know what it was. But I can just imagine he's like on the monorail with the ham. How do you transport it?
He probably has a blanket over it.
It's my friend, and the ham's like talking. He's got the like jitters.
That's funny.
Why wouldn't Disney want to sell that on eBay?
They threw away everything, and that was one thing. He's like, no, you're not throwing this away. For whatever reason.
Mr. Ham.
Yeah,
Mr. Egg, you can get rid of Mr. Egg. Mr. Ham. That's my guy right there.
I wonder if they've got a debt problem. Okay.
You know, I imagine what's in that graveyard. Not that graveyard. I mean the dump that they have on property, because they used to take all the broken attraction rides and just toss them over there. So if you want to find some gold there, I mean, I'm sure you could find something great there.
I mean, they're selling Fast Pass tickets for $100 now. So.
Are they really?
eBay, everything is up for grabs.
All right. So are we ready to move on to our next Epcot attraction?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Let's use our imagination, everyone. Nope, wrong one.
Well, let's listen to it anyways.
This one. This is the one that's currently there.
It's the same song.
It's the same song, but it's different.
Well, yeah. The words are gone.
Yeah. The story's gone. The melody's there.
But you can't kill a purple dragon.
Nope. As much as they might try.
They killed the orange bird.
Yeah.
They did?
Well, they tried to bring it back, but...
Yeah.
He went away for a while, but then he came back, the orange bird.
I'm represented as a popcorn bucket now.
Yep. Guests will wait in long lines and brag on YouTube about their victories of plastic and popcorn.
Now people have to get a virtual queue to get the popcorn bucket. It's ridiculous. Although for the Festival of Arts right now that they have going on at Epcot right now, they're using a bunch of old props from the original attraction.
Yeah, because they were upstairs.
In the Odyssey building.
As popcorn buckets?
No, like, they've got the old Odyssey restaurant.
I've got Figment's brain right here.
So in the Odyssey restaurant, old Odyssey restaurant, it's all Figment. It's like Figment's, like, creative spot or something, whatever. It's where you get your popcorn bucket. But they have, like, an old animatronic figure. It doesn't move, but it's there. They got some of the animations from the original show that they show up against the wall. So it's kind of like, they held on and they care a little bit about the past. But let's go and listen to what was there before.
I thought of the this song's fun.
Yeah.
It holds up. I don't care for
the ride.
The Monty Python actor.
Yeah.
I didn't care for him singing.
So, okay.
Oh, this is childhood right here.
It's a little more annoying.
See, it's a new perspective right there.
Because you didn't grow up.
Not really.
You didn't really see
he was
this.
Our host.
Yeah, it wasn't there when you went.
Mm-mm.
That was my biggest disappointment when we went in 2000, that this attraction wasn't there.
It was so fun when we went in 92.
It was.
We could have spent a lot more time there.
The attraction?
Yes.
That whole pavilion.
Mm-hmm.
Their whole playground and things like that. Which I learned later on that, because they have, like, in their play area, they have the blue screen theater, which me and you, J-Fifth, we got to perform in it. And the guy who's playing Dreamfinder, that's Joe Rohde.
Really?
Yeah, the Imagineer. That's Joe Rohde.
Oh.
Like, this isn't Joe Rohde, but...
The actor.
Joe Rohde, the Imagineer. The Imagineer behind Animal Kingdom, Avatar, all of that. You know, the earrings guy.
Yeah, the earrings guy.
The earrings guy.
Yeah, I saw him in person at Animal Kingdom, and I was like, that's gross when I saw his ear.
Do your ears hang low? Can you tie it in a bow? He's like, yes, I can.
So, I think the transition of music, I think it was a good transition. Like, I'm glad they kept the song itself. I mean, obviously there's there's that love to bring back the original attraction, bring back Dreamfinder in its glory. But we'll see. We'll see how long it'll take.
I remember my friend worked there, and he was like, oh, it's so great. I'm so, like, it was CP. You know, like that honeymoon phase and your CP. And for a month, he's like, this is an amazing attraction. And then, like, after a month, he was like, I hate this. I hate this attraction. And I was like, but you can wear a science scrub. And he's like, I hate that even more. It's Florida, and it's, like, it's June, and I'm wearing two layers.
Right.
And then he's like, oh, we're getting Captain EO. We're going to have celebrities here. And I'm like, no one's going to show up to Florida
It's true. A lot of the employees that work at Figment are so rude.
We had one guy. He was at Mission Space, and then he got hired full time over there, and he was French, and so he had like a little bit more sharper
tone
sometimes, and his delivery, sharper delivery.
Yeah.
And he goes, oh, I hated it there so much. I was so rude to the guests. And I was like, as opposed to you now? Just, oh, no, this is nice me. And I was like, oh.
All right, let's hop on the monorail. Let's make our way over to, I think this is going to be the final one I have. Yes, this will be the final one I have. Oh, wait, no, I have another one. Where are you at? I have another Epcot one. There it is. Okay, so this is what's there now. It's Test Track, the music for Test Track. This is going to be very similar to the Horizons one here. Well, not this song, but
this is OG?
The old one. This is what's there now.
Okay.
This is the updated one, the Tron.
I feel like I'm in a commercial.
Yeah.
Reminds me of a TV show.
NCIS? CSI?
Wow!
That's the Who that sings
that.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's nothing.
It's boring.
It's very generic. Actually, it's a little better than the Test Track music. I did have it on here, but I actually took it off. It's just like a bunch of like car screeching, like oh my gosh, this is horrible. We'll put what's there now, because that other one's not there anymore. But this is what used to be there when Epcot was first opened. And the World of Motion.
I'm waiting for Olaf to join us.
The moon, to go anywhere with never a care to do all there is to be done. It's fun to be free, I am. It's fun to be free.
Oh, this is the winner.
I envision like a prisoner in the 1920s getting out of prison. He's like, it's good to be free.
Written by, and it does not fit Test Track.
Oh no, it does not. You can put this in there now. But written by
that brass in there.
Written by Exitensio.
Really?
Yep.
Wait, so
X.
What attraction was this for?
World of Motion.
World of Motion, okay.
Yes. So now we'll get on the monorail for our last attraction here.
All aboard.
This attraction's kind of interesting when it comes to its music, because the music that's playing there now was its original music, but for a short time, they actually changed the music because the sponsor wanted the song changed, and then later on, they changed it back to the original song. So this is what's there now. Go for it.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream.
We should have invited Mark for those parts.
I know, it's his favorite song.
Favorite Disney song.
It's good. I can smell the vacuum tube.
Yeah.
It's
a great song. It's Walt Disney's theme song.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
So the story goes, so the song is A Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow. Well, General Electric, they wanted a way to boost sales, and this song was telling people to wait for tomorrow. So they wanted a song about today. Now is the time. And so now it's the best time of your life.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time.
I feel
get
like
your credit cards out.
Yeah. I feel like I'm getting brainwashed.
That's interesting. I didn't know that history.
Yesterday's memories may sparkle and gleam. Tomorrow is still but a dream.
Forget about tomorrow. That's a dream. Now.
I mean, it's a lot more catchier.
Both versions written by the Sherman Brothers.
It's an interesting, because it's like, it's hard to pinpoint the time period.
Mm-hmm.
Because it deals with different time periods.
Right.
So you're like, oh, is it this like show that they're showing us, or is it this? And so you can kind of like blend it a little bit. I enjoy both versions, but I'm OG with it because it's what sticks in my head forever. This one, Time Is Now, it's never caught.
I mean, the Time Is Now is catchier, but you can feel like the brainwashing almost.
Well, especially when you know the history behind it, you're like, oh yeah, they're totally telling me to go out and buy things now. Now is the time.
Use your credit card.
Tomorrow's just a dream, right? You've got it made. Let's go. Let's go now.
They're
going to
change Main Street to this song.
And that is a form of persuasion. They always like talk about, like, if you're trying to like pick up someone, you always got to talk about like now. You have to talk about like, we're here now, let us be in the moment. And like, they're really hitting on that persuasion, you know, like sense of feeling, because tomorrow you're gonna die.
Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
So let me ask you this, was there maybe a song that surprised you that you didn't expect to be as good as it was?
The California Coaster.
Yeah, that one, I forgot how good that was.
Yeah.
And listening to it more, like, I was like, this is really good.
Right.
I like this.
I like the reminder of Rocket Rod.
Yes. Yeah. And again, and this is another reminder to me, put the Buzz Lightyear music in so they can hear how, like, how awful it sounds. And that's my opinion, though. I'm not necessarily a big fan of the Buzz Lightyear music on that attraction, but
do you like the attraction?
The attraction's fine.
So yeah, the attraction can improve with better music.
Correct.
Okay.
They tried to go a little sci-fi with it, and it's a little like
cheesy.
I'll play it for you guys after we're done recording. But
you think they should go with more Toy Story 2 opening type music?
Yes.
A little more serious.
Oh,
like
yes.
That? Oh, okay.
Really?
Oh yeah. So, but let us know what you guys thought. What were some surprises to you? Which one of the old songs do you think outperformed the current version? Let us know. You can reach us on any of our social medias, our Twitter, our Facebook, our Instagram. You can also check out our shop. Just check out the link at our website. And anything else?
No.
We're good. All right. Well, thank you, Father Yoda, for joining us this week for this fun episode. It was great hearing your perspective.
Thank you for letting
this.
Me crash the party.
Of yes. course.
And until next time, auf Wiedersehen. Thank you for joining us on this week's episode of the Matterhorn Yodelers. Please remember, before your bobsled comes to a complete stop, to follow us on Facebook and Instagram. And remember,
remain seated, please. Permanecer sentados, por favor.